Hi everyone. Once again, my name is Darwin. I welcome you back to this channel that's all about architecture, engineering and construction. And where we also are all about bettering the African narrative, okay? So I realize that some of you get your houses designed already, and you're now beginning to do the construction. But along the way, as you do the construction, or even after you've completed the construction, you realize that spaces don't actually appear to be the way they were earlier on depicted to look like. For example, the plan looked so beautiful for you and it looked so functional. But after you've built, you realize that some places do not have access to natural light, or you realize that the aeration is not enough, you know. And these are things that are kind of irreversible after the house has been complete. So today, if you are an architect or not an architect, I thought that we should take you through the guiding principles that we go through while we are designing these houses, so that we avoid such circumstances or such incidences to happen, okay? So with all that being said, so we are just going to go right into the video, okay? So let's look at the exterior first. One of the main important things of the house to look on the exterior is the outside of the house. The outside of the house is supposed to be beautiful, at least from three angles. Giving an example of this project that we are actually working on, we've been working on it for quite some time. You can see that if I look at this house from this direction, it still looks a bit beautiful. When I turn and look at it from this house, it has to look beautiful. And when I look at it from this, from the back of it, it still definitely has to look beautiful. And as well from this side, still has to look beautiful. Of course, I'm not saying that this is possible in all circumstances, you know. And in certain circumstances, you might notice that you might not have to make all the sides like that, like this one. But you just do your best to make sure that you achieve beauty as much as possible. So there are basically just about three things that make a house, or that make a certain side of a house beautiful. One of them is corners, another one is windows, and another one is balconies. You can see that as we add balconies on this side, they add to the beauty of the house. Now this house specifically is a Mediterranean design, okay? But you realize that what is actually making the front beautiful mainly is the balconies that are actually adding to the beauty of the house from whichever angle you look at it from the front, okay? Of course, I'm taking you through the raw version of the design, the unrendered version. Well, we've not yet added vegetation, we've not yet done the landscaping, but we've done most of the basic work that really needs to be done on this house, okay? So the balconies make the house beautiful. You can see on the front, that's why even here at the back, we added some balconies, you know, to make the back look as beautiful if you choose to see it from this side. Then the other thing is corners. If your house does not have enough corners, it's basically going to look like a box. Okay, and the house being, now just imagine like one of these edges was straight, this one was straight, the whole house is going to look like a box. Even the roof plan, you can see, is being guided by the general shape of the house, which actually makes the roof plan beautiful as well, as you can see in this. Okay, then the other thing that we need to consider, now leaving the outside, one of the other major things that we need to consider is the functionality of the spaces that are inside, okay? Now talking about functionality of spaces, there are quite a number of things we need to consider. One of the things is that we know there are private places in the building. We know there are also shared places in the building, okay? And then we also know that we design the spaces inside based on functionality. Now, using this project as an example, if I'm to take you through, let me just create my cutting plane. As you can see right here, this is the main front porch, okay? While you enter into the main porch, you enter into the living area. It's the living area. Of course, this is not yet a complete design, and this does not actually include the interior design, but to give you an idea of how the furniture can be arranged to achieve the functionality of this area. You can see that the living area is as close as possible to the dining area. This right here is the dining area. Now, with this dining area, you see that even when you guys are eating something, while the screen is over there, you could still watch the screen. Of course, not everyone really considers these things. Not everyone really thinks it's that important. I mean, if it's mealtime, it's mealtime. Either way, this really depends on the client and what the client actually wants from their design and what they would love to achieve. But as you can see, the dining is close to the kitchen. There's a kitchen bar here for simple meals such as breakfast, you know, stuff like that. So as you go into the kitchen area, let me just head to the kitchen area. You see that the kitchen area is placed in a position where it is close to the dining, okay? And there's an exit door that actually exits to the outside of the house, to the back of the house. You can see there is a window here that actually brings light into this area. There is another window that brings light into the dining area, another window that brings light into the dining area. So this place is really having enough natural light. Then for the living room, you realize that there's enough light coming from here, enough light coming from this strip window you see over here, enough light coming through this strip window, coming through this door. Really, lighting is not a problem here in this case, for example. So as we head now, as we are talking about the kitchen, you see that the kitchen has a small pantry. It has, of course, these cabinets that you see here. Then it has a small pantry where you can store some things. Of course, you can decide to put shelves in this place or whatever you would wish to, you know. Then this right here is the maid's this is the maid's room, okay? Or you could call it a staff quarter, or you could call it a boys' quarter. It doesn't necessarily, it's not necessarily out of the house, but it's within the house, but it's kind of detached. It could be a boys' quarter, it could be a staff quarter, it could be the maid's quarter, you know. And it's as well self-contained specifically for this project. Then, as you can see, while we were heading to this side, there are staircases that take you to the upper side, which I'm going to discuss shortly. Then there is this aisle that actually leads you into the guest's bedroom. Now, the guest's bedroom is over here, as you can see it. The guest bedroom is self-contained as well. Okay, we have a bathroom here. I'm going to later discuss why our bathroom has been done like this. But let's first proceed. Then there is a shared toilet for the visitors. Any visitors that come around into the house, that come to visit the house, and maybe they want to take a short call or a long call, they could just come over here from the living room and take this door and get into here. Then we have a small laundry here where you could do the laundry, you could do the ironing and all that. Okay. Then this is the stair that actually takes you to the upper floor. Of course, you have a porch at the back of the house. Okay. And then the rest is pretty much straightforward. Okay. Save for these other outside spaces that we can see here. These are just ordinary planters on the outside of the house. Okay. So basically, that's it for the ground floor. Now, this house specifically has 4 bedrooms. It has the guest bedroom down. And then it has a maid's bedroom on this outside. So now we are going to go to the upper floor and see what is there for us on the upper floor. Okay. So now coming to the top of the house, remember we've taken our stairs from down. Okay. We've now come right onto this floor. Okay. There's a small home office over here. Just a small home office where you could do your reading, you could do your office work. Of course, it definitely has a nice balcony over here that looks to the back of the house where you are exposed to very minimal noise. And then as you come to this floor, you could take an aisle, okay, or you could take a foyer that leads you onto the outside balcony that you see right here, as you saw in the 3Ds, okay? Then you have a false balcony for this bedroom. It's a false balcony because it looks like a balcony but actually isn't a balcony. Then you have some planters here, you know. This bedroom is as well self-contained. I will explain again why we are making our bathrooms in this format and in this format. Then there is this bedroom as well that is self-contained, okay? And then we finally have the master bedroom. Now, as you enter the master bedroom from here, okay, you realize that it's bigger than most of the other rooms. There are a lot of things you can do in this. It has a walk-in closet, as you can see here. You can walk into the closet and do all your dressing work here and there. And then you can as well go into the bathroom and shower. This is the master bath, okay? As you can see, the master bedroom as well has a balcony that is very nice for chilling. And then, so now talking about this, the bathrooms, like I had earlier on told you about, we always want to create a shower tray, on this side of the bathroom, okay? You realize that a bathroom needs to be divided into wet areas and dry areas, so that when you are not using the shower, the bathroom definitely has to be dry, and when you are using the shower, the bathroom remains dry. Because you heard of issues of people sliding in bathrooms and falling down, so it's important that you demarcate the area for the bathroom, so that even if someone showers from here and does whatever they do in their showering, the water does not cross to this other part of the bathroom, okay? So this part of the bathroom remains as dry as possible, okay? That is how we're actually doing our bathrooms. So as you can see, this aisle or this foyer, you know, there's a lot of things you can do with this corridor. You can put some artwork. You can put some artwork here and there. You know, as someone walks into the outside, the balcony to the outside, okay, where you can hold small parties here and there. Okay, then we had, let me just turn this again. So you can see that we have a carport that can accommodate up to 3 cars very comfortably. Then the other thing that we might not have mentioned at the first time are the ducts. You can see that throughout our building we have ducts all over. For example, this is now a duct. Now the way these ducts function is that they bring water that comes along the gutters from this roof, okay? Then as it comes along the gutters, it has to pass through this duct and then take the water safely to the ground. And then the other issue is that all the plumbing pipes that actually carry waste, that carry wastewater or carry sewage from these toilets, this toilet and this one, for example, is that all those pipes are actually supposed to pass through this duct and go down to the manhole or to the inspection chamber where they can be safely disposed to the septic tank, okay? That is really important. You realize that a lot of houses in this country, they have issues of, many people do not really consider this part of design. So you find that people are having pipes running on the surface of the wall, which actually did not even appear in the artistic impressions, which we believe is not really, it's not a good idea, you know. Why would we be doing that when we can avoid it, okay? Of course, there are some pipes which for which you don't provide ducts, like this pipe that is just coming from the gutter over here, okay? Then you can see the planning of our roof is that we do as much as possible to avoid we do our best to avoid things like leakages here and there, okay? Now, talking about the general factors, things such as access to light, you can see that our house has enough windows for aeration, okay? Of course, you put this little ventilation here for aeration. There are many other ways that we can do our ventilation, not necessarily having to use this. Okay, this really depends on the budget of the client, and you know, the other thing you might want to notice is that if you look at all our bathrooms, all our rooms, all our spaces, they have access to natural light. The bathrooms have access to natural light, like you see on this one, like you see on this one, like you see on the bathroom for the master bedroom, sorry, right here, as you can see here. Then as you can also see this window right here for this bathroom, you can see that all bathrooms actually have access to natural light, which is really good and also good for aeration as well as taking out the waste. Of course, this does not apply to every country. In certain countries like the UK, like the USA, as I've seen, their conditions are a whole lot different than ours, you know. For most of them, most of the buildings in the UK and in the USA, they pass most of their plumbing works under the ceiling before they cast the ceiling, okay? Which can be quite costly, but for them it's not as costly because it's not only the pipes of plumbing that pass there. They have to pass through their insulation. They also have to pass their heating systems and all that. We don't need heating here. Our climate or our weather is quite stable. So we don't have extremely cold conditions and we don't have extremely hot conditions. So we don't need, there's no need you should be putting a lot of air conditioning into the house in a place like here in Uganda, you know. That is that can be quite expensive, you know. Basically, I think that is it for now, unless there are other things. So I'll show you the impressions after you've added the vegetation, so that you can see how the house in the end is meant to look. But basically, we consider all the factors that are really sufficient to give you comfort in your house, and still at the same time not cost you a lot of money, both at the construction stage and in the life cycle. For example, lighting, you don't have to keep your lights in the bathroom on just because it's dark. During the day, there's enough light really. You only need to turn on your lights only during the night, okay? If there's anything that I've not considered, you guys can let me know in the comments so that we can figure it out, so that we can explain more about it. Otherwise, for now, I think that is it, you know? I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you've learned something from this video. So the next time you have your plan designed, you need to check your house. You need to check it for most of these things so that you don't go wrong in the construction and start rebooting after you've done the plans, okay? Otherwise, thank you very much for your time, guys, and have a good time.